Hey, my name's Steve. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. This video will cover the 2019 HSC Mathematics Extension 1 past paper in question 13. So here is the part 8 in question 13. The question is, use the substitution of u equal to cos x squared to evaluate this integration. So under this substitution, we have to change the integration from dx to du. So we have dx equal to 2, we bring the 2 to the front, r. We have negative 2 cos x, and then times the triangle of the cos x to have sine x. Okay, so this one equal to negative sine 2x. So from here we have dx equal to du over negative sine 2x. Okay, you can use this whole term to replace this dx. And then we have to change the integration interval. For the x, it's from 0 to a quarter of pi, but for u is different. So we have when x equal to a quarter of pi, u equal to cos pi on 4 squared. So it will be equal to square of 2 over 2 squared equal to half. And then when x equal to 0, u equal to cos 0 squared. So cos 0 is 1 squared, and then it's 1. So under this substitution, we are doing the integration of sine 2x over 4 plus this cos x squared equal to u. So we are doing u, and then replace this part to the dx. We have du over negative sine 2x. Okay, and it's from 1 to half. 1 to half. Make sure your order is matching this interval. Don't flip it over. It's not always have to be a small number to a bigger number. So when x equal to 1, equal to 0, u is 1. So here 0 is 1. And when x equal to a quarter of pi, u is half. So we have half over here. Okay? So sine 2 pi, we cross out. So we have a negative sign over here. So become half 1, negative 1 over 4 plus u du. Okay, so we have a negative sign over here. We can bring the negative sign into the front of the integration, or we can use this negative sign to flip this interval over to become integration from half to 1. We have 1 over 4 plus u du. Okay, so here equal to ln 4 plus u from half to 1. Then we can submit the 1 into here and the half over here. Equal to ln, summing the 1 into here, we have ln 5 minus summing the half into the 4, we have ln 9 over 2. So ln 5 minus ln 9 over 2. So we have equal to this number divided by this number, we have ln 5 divided by 9 over 2. We have 5 times 2, we have 10 over 9. That's your final answer, okay? Log ln 10 over 9. Okay, let's go to the part B. Part B is in the expansion of 5x plus 2 to the power of 20. The coefficients of these two terms, x to the power of k, x to the power of k plus 1, are equal. So the question asks you, what's the value of k? So we have to find these two terms first. in the expansion of this 5x plus 2 to the power of 20, we have the xk term equal to 20k times this 5x to the power of k, and then times this 2 to 20 minus k. Okay, and for the term of kx to the power of k plus 1, we have 20k plus 1, and then oh, 5x k plus 1 times 2, 20 minus k minus 1. So 20 minus k, minus k plus 1 is 20 minus k minus 1. Okay, so here is, that's okay. Okay, we bring the coefficient. So the coefficient of this term is, so we have 20k times 5 to the power of k times 2 to the power of 20 minus k times x to the power of k. So here is the coefficient of the term of x plus to the power of k. Okay, the next one is we have 20k plus 1, 5 to the power of k plus 1 times 2 to the power of 19 minus k times x to the power of k plus 1. This part equal to this part based on the question. So we have 20k, we have 20 factorial divided by 20 minus k factorial times k factorial. Okay, and then we keep equal times 5 to the power of k times 20, times 2 to the power of 20 minus k equal to, so here would be 20 factorial divided by, so we have 20 minus k minus 1. So actually we have 19 minus k factorial, and then times k plus 1 factorial. Okay, and then keep going, bring this down, times 5 to the power of k plus 1 times 2, 19 minus k. Okay, so 20 factorial, we can cross out. So here 20 minus k factorial, and here's 19 factorial, minus k factorial. So here, so 20 minus k factorial equal to 20 minus k times 19 minus k factorial. Is that right? So this part equals to this part, and both sides have 19 minus k factorial, which means we can cross out this factorial, 19 minus k factorial, and this one, which means on the left hand side, we still have 20 minus k. Okay? So we have more. So we still have 20 minus k on the left hand side. So k factorial and k plus 1 factorial, because k plus 1 factorial equal to k plus 1 times k factorial. Okay, so k factorial and here's k factorial, we can cross out, which means we still have k plus 1 on the right hand side. So we still have k plus 1 on the right. And 5 to the power of k and 5 to the power of k plus 1. And we can cross out here. We still have 1, 5 over here. So we can cross out here, but we still have 1, 5. And 2 to the power of 20 minus k, 2 to the power of 19 minus k. We can cross out this one. And we still have 1, 2 on the left. Okay? So on the left, we still have 2 over 20 minus k. And the right, we still have 5 over k plus 1. Okay, so we have 2 times k plus 1 equal to 5 times 20 minus k. So that we have 2k plus 1 equal to 5 20 minus k. Then we can solve the value of k from this equation. Then we can expand this one. We have 2k plus 2 equal to 100 minus 5k. So 5k bring to the left, we have 7k. 100 minus 2, we have 98, which means we have k equal to 98 divided by 7. K equal to 98 divided by 7 equal to 14. Okay, so when the coefficient of k to the power of x to the power of k and x to the power of k plus 1 are equal, the value of k has to be 14, which means the term of x to the power of 14 and the term of x to the power of 15, they have the same coefficient. Okay, so your final result is k equal to 14. Okay, let's go to part C. The question is, a particle moves in a straight line. At time t seconds, the particle has a displacement of x meter, a velocity of v meters per second, and acceleration is a meters per second per second. The particle has a displacement 0 meters, and the velocity is 2 meters per second. The acceleration is given by this function a equal to negative 2 e to the power of negative x. So here is the relationship between the acceleration and the displacement. The velocity of the particle is always positive. So here is also a condition, always positive. The first question is, we have to show that v equal to 2 times e to the power of negative x over 2. So here is the function for v with respect to x. In terms of this function, we don't have a t. We need this formula. You can find this formula at the end of your past paper. So we have the second derivative of x with respect to t. So actually here is acceleration equal to d. So here is doing the derivative of half v squared with respect to x. So here is the function of v with in terms of x. So here is the v in terms of x. Here is the function equal to acceleration. Okay, so that we have. So we are using this part. We have d over dx to half v squared equal to, so this a, we have the a function from the question here. So equal to negative 2 e to the power of negative x. So we have the x over here. We can bring the dx to the other side to do the integration. So we have, and then we do the integration on the both sides. We have half v squared equal to integration of negative 2 e to the power of x with respect to x. Okay, so this negative sign is from the chain rule of e, this negative x. So this integration, we can bring the 2 into the front to have 2. This negative sign is from here. Okay, so 2 equal to 2 times e to the power of negative x, and then plus c. So from here, we have to find the value of c to confirm the equation for v. We have the initial condition is when the initial particle displacement is 0 meters and the velocity is 2 meters per second, which means when x equal to 0, v equal to 2. Right? So we have when x equal to 0, v equal to 2. So we sub in this 0 to here and the 2 over here to become half times 2 squared equal to 2 times e to the power of. So here it will be 0 plus c. So here is 4. This will be 2 equal to, here's 1, so here 2 plus c. So that we have c equal to 0. Okay, so from here we can have here. So we have half v squared equal to, so here is 0, so here just half v squared equal to 2 e to the power of negative x, and then we can times 2 on the both sides to become v squared equal to 4 e negative x. Okay, we can keep going with v equal to positive negative 4 e negative x. Because the question say the velocity of the particle is always positive, which means this v has to be positive at any time. So we can't choose the value of negative for the v. So v had to be positive square root of 4e to the negative x. So we can bring this 4 outside the square root to become 2e. And we can combine this square root into this to the power of negative x to become negative x over 2. Okay, so here is the question what we want to ask to solve. So we have v equal to 2 times e to the power of negative x divided by 2. Here's the first part. Okay, let's go to the second part. Second part is find an expression for x as a function of t. So x is the displacement, it's a function for displacement in terms of t, it's time t. From the first part, we have v equal to 2 times e to the power of negative x over 2. Because we have to know when x is the function of displacement. If we do the first derivative of dx, but in terms of dt, here is the velocity, right? Which means is from here we have dx over dt equal to this part v, 2 to the times e to the negative x over 2. But here we have a function of x, but here's dt. If we bring this dt to the other side, we can't do the integration to t. We don't have t here. So that we have flip this 2 over and then we bring the dx to the other side, then we can do the integration on the right hand side with respect to the x. So we can flip the over to become dx dt over dx. So this flip over, this one flip over, this 2 become half e to the power, so we can times to the power, so this part to the power of negative 1, so negative 1. So negative become positive. So e to the power of x over 2. Okay? Alright. Then we can bring this dx to the right hand side and then we can do the integration. We have dt over half e to the power of x over 2 dx. Then we can do the integration on the both sides to become t equal to integration half e x over 2 dx. So we can do the integration for this function with respect to x for here. This half is from the chain rule for x over 2. You see that? This half is from here. So this integration is equal to a e to the power of x over 2, and then plus c. Okay, so we have to find the value of c, and then we can have a function for t in terms of x. So the initial condition is when t equal to 0, x equal to 0, or we can say when x equal to 0, t equal to 0. So the first one. So here, the initial particle has a displacement 0 meters, which means when t equal to 0, x equal to 0. When we're using the condition for this equation is when x equal to 0, t equal to 0. Okay? We sum in this t and x. So we have when x equal to 0, t equal to 0. Summing this 0 to here and here, we have 0 equal to e to the power of, so here is 0, plus c. So e to the power of 0 is 1. So 1 plus c equal to 0. Then we have c equal to negative 1. And then we bring this c over here, we have t. We have t equal to e to the power of x over 2 minus 1. So here is the function for t of x. But the question is, we need expression for t, x, as a function of t. So we have to find the value of x in terms of t from this function. So we can bring the one to the outside. We have e to the power of x over 2 equal to t plus 1. Okay, and x over 2 equal to ln t plus 1. And then we can times 2 on the both sides to become x equal to 2 ln t plus 1. Okay, so at the end we have the function of x in terms of t. So it's the expression of x as a function of t. So here's our final answer. I've mentioned that this question is not in the 2020 syllabus. Okay. So this question is the whole question C is not in the 2020 syllabus. Okay. You probably won't see this question in the exam. Okay. This kind of question. Okay. Let's go to question D. The point O is on a sloping plane that forms an angle of 45 degrees to the horizontal. So here is a sloping plane formed 45 degrees with the horizontal. A particle is projected from point O. So here's the point O, projected from here and then going down over here. And the particle hits the point A, so hitting the point A with the sloping plane. And so here's the diagram over here. The equation of the line of OA is y equal to negative x. So this sloping plane is y equal to negative x. Okay, and the equation of the motion of the particle is x equal to 18t, y equal to 18 square root of 3t minus 5t squared. And where t is the time in seconds, and after projection, so after here, the t is counting. Okay, also we don't have to prove these equations. Okay, so we just use that. Okay, under the question D, the first part is to find the distance of OA. We have to find the distance of OA. Between the point of projection and the point where the particle hits the sloping plane, actually we need to find the distance of this OA. Okay? Because on this sloping plane is y equals to negative x, which means the coordinate of this point A is x0, then y is negative x0. If we can find the x, then we can find the y, right? Because here is y equal to negative x. From this motion equation we have, so at this point we want to x equal to negative y. And then we can sub in these two equations into this relationship of x and y. So that we have x 18t equal to negative 18 square root of 3t minus 5t squared. Okay, from this equation we can find the value of t. Break down the brackets, we have 18t equal to, so negative, we got positive 5t squared. Here's negative minus 18 square root of 3t. Okay, we can bring this one into the other side. We have 5t squared minus 18 square root of 3 minus, we can combine these two, then it's plus 18t equal to 0. Okay, factor out the t, we have t times 5t minus 18 square root of 3 plus 18. Okay, equal to 0. Okay, from here, this t equal to 0, or 5t equal to this part. So we have t equal to 0, or 5t equal to 18 square 3 plus 18. So t equal to this part divided by 5. So we have t equal to 18 square 3 plus 18 divided by 5. Okay, because x equal to 18t, we have t over here. Then we can sub in the t to the x, we can find the value for x. So x equal to 18 times 18 square 3 plus 18 over 5. Okay, then we can find the x, and the y is negative x, will be negative this part. We can sub in this t to find the value of y, but because here is t and t squared, and you need a lot of calculation, then we can just using this negative to x, then we can get the y. And the distance of OA equal to the coordinate of this one squared plus this one squared, right? So x squared plus y squared. So we have x squared plus this one, we have x0 squared plus negative x0 squared. So here negative square actually is, so we have 2x0 squared inside. So we have square of 2x0. So this x0 is this x. Okay, we can sub in this one into here. We have square of 2 times 18 square of 3 plus 18. Divided by 5. Use a calculator to find the value of this whole term. Is roughly, your answer is equal to 250.4 meters. Or you can keep one decimal place or two decimal places, it should be fine. So the distance of OA is about 215.4 meters. Okay, so here's the answer for part A. Okay, let's go to the second part. The question is, what is the size of the acute angle that the path of the particle makes with the sloping plane as the particle hits the point A? Let's have a look at the graph again. Here is the sloping plane, y equal to negative x. So the particle is projected from the zero and then hits the sloping plane at A. At this point, the slope of the particle is actually going this way. So here's the slope of the particle at this point. And the question asks for this angle, theta. Okay? And because here is the slope, we can find the angle for this slope, and then from this angle to find this one. We can find from right angle triangle over here. So here is the change of x, here is the change of y. I assume in this triangle. So here is delta x, this is delta y. Because this changing y is decreasing, going this way. That's why when we finding the tangent, the slope of the slope is negative. Actually, is this beta, this beta. So when we do tan beta equal to the delta y equal to the delta x, because here is a negative. Delta y is decreasing, so here's we got a negative sign over here. But if we can find this angle, because here is a right angle triangle, then we can get this one. And because here is a 45 degrees with the vertical line, so here is 45 degrees. So if we can find this angle, then using 45 degrees subtract this angle, we can find this angle. So here is the alpha, so equal to this one, right? So we're trying to get this one from this angle. At the end, we can find this theta, okay? So we try to find this one. We can use this angle, okay, alpha. Alpha would be, so because alpha and beta is sum up together is 180. If we have tan alpha equal to negative delta y over delta x. So we change the delta x from negative to positive. We put a negative sign over here. Then we can find the angle of alpha. So this delta y is the change of y per second. So we can find the first derivative of the y with respect to t. Also delta x is, we do the derivative of x in terms of t. So we have negative delta y. So here would be 18 square root of 3 minus, here would be 10 t. So here's the delta y over the delta x. So 18t is 18. Okay, so here would be negative over 10t minus 18 square root 3 over 18. Okay, so because the t at this time we have get it from the first question is, so t equal to 18 plus 18 square root 3 over 5. So at this point, the t equal to this part. You can sub in this t into here to find the value of tan alpha. So equal to 10 times 18 plus 18 square root 3 over 5 minus 18 square root 3 divided by 18. Okay, and alpha, okay, we can simplify this function. So this 5, this 10, we got 2. We can factor out this 18. With this 18, we can cross out all the 18 out. Okay, so we have 2 1 plus square root 3 minus square root 3. Okay, so we got 1 over here. So we still have 2. So 1 plus square 3 minus square 3. So when we 2 times this part, we got 2 plus 2 square 3 minus 3. Minus square 3, we have 2 plus square 3. Okay, so alpha will equal to the inverse 10, 2 plus square of 3. Use a calculator, you can find the angle for alpha is 75 degrees. Okay, so this angle is 75 degrees because here is a right angle, which means here is 90 minus 75. So here's a 15. This angle 45, which means alpha equal to 45 minus 15. So alpha or theta equal to 45 degrees minus 90 degrees minus 75 degrees. So this 90 minus 75 is this angle, this part. And then we're using 45, subtract this angle, we got theta. Okay, so here is 15. 45 minus 15, we got 30. 30 degrees. So the acute angle from the path of the particle made with the swimming plan is 30 degrees. So 30 will be your final answer. Okay? Yeah, that will be all for the question 13. I'll see you in the next video for the last question of this paper, question 14. See you next time.